This is a viral integral that students at the Nanjing University of Aero and Astronautics had to solve to access the internet in their dining hall. The password is the first 8 digits of the final answer. What's more, they couldn't use a calculator. Luckily though, it's possible to solve this problem without hours of calculus and integration rules. We mostly need geometry and a little bit of algebra. So let's get into it. Also, just in case anyone is unfamiliar with what an integral is, the most basic explanation I can offer is that it represents the total area under a given function between these two x values. One important thing to note though is that area above the x-axis is considered positive, while area below the x-axis is considered negative. This concept will be very important for reducing the amount of work it takes to solve for the Wi-Fi password later. Onto the actual problem now, the first thing we want to do is distribute this square root expression to the others inside the parentheses. This gives us the sum of two separate expressions and means we can split this big integral into two smaller ones that we can tackle separately. Let's start with the one on the right because it seems easier. Because this 1/2 is a constant, we can pull it outside the integral and we're left with the square root of 4 minus x squared. If you're familiar with geometric equations, you might recognize that this represents the top half of a circle with a radius of 2. But if it doesn't connect just from the expression, here's the breakdown. We can verify it's a circle of radius 2 by setting this expression equal to y, then squaring both sides. Next, we group all of our variables on one side. This gives us the equation of a square with radius 2. Then, to show it's only the top half of this circle, we solve for y by reversing what we just did, and instead of y equaling plus and minus this expression, we only consider the positive portion because that's what we're trying to integrate. And since our integral goes from negative 2 to 2, that means we're finding this shaded portion of the function's area. And because we know the area of a semicircle is just 1/2 pi r squared, we can substitute the integral with that formula and barely have to do any calculus to get rid of it. Moving forward, our next step is to plug our radius of 2 into the formula and get 1/4 times pi times 4. The 4s cancel out and we're left with pi. And now that we took care of that, we can focus our attention on the much nastier looking integral. But before we start trying to integrate this behemoth of an expression, let's talk about the concept of even and odd functions. An even function is a function that has a graph symmetrical to the y-axis, and an odd function has a graph symmetrical to the line y equals negative x. Mathematically, what this means is that in an even function for any x value, the negative of that x value outputs the same y value. And in an odd function for any input x that results in an output y, the negative of that x results in the negative of that y. If we graph the three main equations in this second integral over the interval negative 2 to 2, we see that the square root and cosine functions are even and that the x cubed is odd. Multiplying two even functions results in an even function, and multiplying an even function by an odd function results in an odd function. So we can say that this whole expression is an odd function. And then from there, we can leverage the inherent symmetry in that definition to simplify this problem greatly. Since our expression is odd, any positive area under the curve over an interval must have a negative counterpart over the negative of that interval. For an easy visual, take the line y equals x. If we start at 0 and go in the positive direction, the area under the graph will be this triangle. Likewise, if we go the same distance in the negative direction, we get the same triangle, but because it's under the x-axis, the area is negative. This means the total area we get over their combined interval is 0. Going back to our original function, we can apply this exact same principle because our interval is symmetric around x equals 0. And what that means is we can substitute this whole integral with 0 without needing to do hours of complex calculations. So what we end up with for our final answer is 0 plus pi, which is just pi. And that means the Wi-Fi password is the first 8 digits of pi, which I actually don't know, so I'll have to look it up. They are 3.14159265. And there we have it, we're finally able to access the university's Wi-Fi, and if you want to put it to good use, you should check out some of my other videos. But if not, that's okay. Thank you for watching.